my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now, I'd...
Stop.
Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun... Grimbley gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbley gun on me right now. Oh, I swear. swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now. Oh, I swear to God, if I had my Grimbly gun on me right now.
Here comes the boy. Hello, boy. Welcome. Hey, lads. What's the good word? It's ya boy. I'm here. We're here. We're ready. Another Friday stream upon us. It is Friday. It do be Friday, though. Truly the most relaxing day of the week. Or so they say. Well, actually, I guess that would probably either be Saturday or Sunday. Maybe Sunday if you're... Sunday if you're Christian. Sunday if you're Christian, Saturday if you're Jewish. If you're Jewish, Sunday is the first day of the week? Of course, I think I've heard non-Jewish people say that as well. Sunday doesn't seem like the first day of the week to me. I don't know about you guys, but I never, I don't cotton to that. I don't cotton to that mindset. I can't support that kind of thinking. Sunday, the first day of the week? Monday's the first day of the week, obviously. Max, I'm in love with your buddy Yotam. Well, you'll have to bring that up with him. I'm not his keeper. I'm sure he'll be thrilled to hear it. Thrilled! Oh, he'll be thrilled. Oh, there will be a thrill to be had. Now, if I told you guys, if I were to tell you guys, there's a movie in theaters playing right now that's great. Would you want to go see it? It's not just good. It's not even just really good. It's not even incredibly good. It's great. And great is better than all the goods. Literally every good.
$10 from Saito Kirikuti and Amwagunigu. Smiley face. Smiley face. Smiley face.
Great. Thank you for that strange super chat. Great is better than all the goods. None of the goods, no matter how you describe them, are as good as the great. Great is the best thing that a thing can be. Yesterday I saw Late Night with the Devil. It was so great. Not even it was so good, just great. It was so great. And if you don't want to believe me, and you're the kind of person that does factor in just like the general public consensus, what most people are saying. It has a 97 on Rotten Tomatoes right now. That's really close to perfect. If we're assuming that 100 is a perfect movie, that's really close. If you're someone who likes going to the movies, which I don't know if that's a lot of people, which is probably why so few people are going to the movies these days, because they just don't... They view watching a movie at home as like an equally valid experience, which, you know, that's a good experience too. You can watch a movie like that and it can be good. But if you enjoy going to the movies, but you're a person like me who loves the movie-going experience...
$5 from Chocolate Gamer 12. What up, Max, my dude? How's it going, bro?
It's going alright. You know, it's kind of a little stiff today. Thank you for the super chat. You know, I love the movie-going experience. I love the big screen. I love the loud speakers. I love sitting in the dark room, having the nice big comfy chair. I love the popcorn. I love the soda. But often I'm just like, there's never anything playing, though, that's any good. It's, you know, all they play these days is a bunch of schlock. Just a bunch of reboots and remakes. A bunch of movies about things I don't really care about. But if you love going to the movies, but you wish there were more great movies that are fun to watch, if you go to see this movie, if you go to see Late Night with the Devil, you will have fun. I promise you, you will have fun watching this movie. It's a fun movie. You know, obviously not the best movie for small children. Probably better for consenting adults who are okay with R-rated movies, okay with horror movies. It's not the scariest movie in the world, but it's so much fun. It's so much fun to watch from start to finish that it, regardless of how scary it is, it doesn't matter. And it's funny, it's got some great bits in it. It's so entertaining. I had so much fun while watching it, and after it was over, I was like, man, I was actually glad I went to the movies for once. Max, I'm scared of you? I'm sorry. Nothing I can do about that. You know, you shouldn't fear me. I'm just a man. I'm just a humble man. I'm a kind-hearted man. Wouldn't you guys say I'm kind? I think I'm very kind. I can be kind. I'm not interested in hurting anybody. But because nobody goes to the movies anymore, the worst part of going to the movies are the other people at the movies. I think we can all pretty much agree on this. But because nobody goes anymore, and because this movie isn't exactly doing gangbusters, if you go to see Late Night with the Devil...
Snippers, remember that time you wore a hear monitor, and when the doc took it off and looked at it, he said, wait a minute. This guy's heart rate is consistent with a man who jerks off and smokes weed all day.
You're not going to believe this, but they said that the results of my blood monitor, my blood pressure monitor were fine. They said they were normal.
$10 from Saito Kiriku TM. I honestly agree. I think entertainment has lost its charm throughout the decade due to them caring more about rating,
yeah,
money, and not about the movies themselves. In my opinion, at least.
But that's why this is a great movie to see, though, because it's just a fun little isolated experience, you know? And I was sitting alone in a giant empty theater. The best way to go to the movies. None of the riffraff, you know? Keep the riffraff out of here. Just me in here. It's great. It's great to see a movie that way. It feels weird at first, because we're used to being in a room full of people when we see a movie. But if you get used to it, it's pretty great. It is pretty great. But yeah, I got the results for my heart monitor that I was wearing last week. They said they were just normal.
$5 from Here Comes Trouble. Outer Wilds? Savor this one. I mean it. Don't boomer too hard. TA checks for many hours of entertainment less than three.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of people say this game I'm playing today is very special. It's a very special game. I don't exactly know what you mean when you say don't boomer it too hard. Especially since you preceded that by saying savor this one. Is boomering a video game when you just kind of rush to the end? Maybe. I don't know. Thank you for the super chat. They said the results of my heart monitor were fine. Were normal. Maybe when you're sitting in a chair playing a horror game, which jump scares you, it does elevate your heart rate, but not like all that much more than it would if you were like exercising, if you were going for a jog. And so they looked at the results and they were like, oh, this guy must jog a lot. This guy's been exercising. And really, I was playing Shipwreck 64. It is Fan Art Friday, you guys. What do we got in here? Let me take a look at what we got in here. What do we got? No, happy face. Happy face as we explore the artwork. They're gonna draw me pregnant. Very strange. Please, nobody draw Goofball pregnant. Me saying fuck you, that's me and Burnbot switching clothing, I guess? Very cute, very adorable. You should watch Everything Everywhere All at Once. It's amazing, and amazing is better than great. Amazing is better than great.
$10 from Curtis Fountain. It's a very weird and unique gameplay that will remind you of a certain movie. I'm certain of this.
Of a certain
also,
movie?
Your blood pressure is good.
So of a certain this. Movie? I guess I'll have to see if I can try to guess what the movie is that you're referring to based solely on the gameplay itself. Amazing is better than great. I would agree with you on that, but if amazing is in play, if we're using the word amazing, at that point I might say that Late Night with the Devil is an amazing movie. I just don't know if the word amazing is a word that I use a lot. If you watch it, you'll like it. Azora, why are you bugging me? Why are you bugging me on Discord? What? Why are you bugging me with this? For fuck's sake, Zora. Zora, I'm trying to stream, genius. Hello? For fart's sake. There's me making a goofy face. Very cute.
$5 from Zog Chones. When is the brain dump anime coming out? Where can I buy a goofball body pillow?
I don't know about a goofball body pillow, but you can buy a BurnBot body pillow. Of course, it's just a square, because it's just a throw pillow. God, if I had my diggity gun on me right now! Boy, I'll tell you what, if I had my diggity gun on me! Love that bit. It's a great bit. Big fan of that bit. BurnBot and Goofball ripping my lips open. Very creepy. Straight white man, don't tell no secrets. Hey, it's Dippy Dog! We love Dippy Dog. We love him. That's what went wrong in that movie, Late Night with the Devil. They summoned Dippy Dog. Everyone knows you don't do that. You open the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, do not summon Dippy Dog. Genesis chapter 1, verse 2, do not fucking summon Dippy Dog! Don't do it. Just don't do it. We do have to get into it, though. Y'all best not be summoning that Dippy Dog. Let sleeping Dippy Dogs lie. Do not summon them. It will only end poorly for you. Everybody put a kibosh on the super chats for now. Oops, just got one. When am I going to get the life-size Max G pillow? You can make one on your own. You can make that of your own accord, and I won't sue you or anything for that. But I don't think that's something I'm going to be distributing anytime soon. But everybody, please put a kibosh on the super chats as we say our prayer. Please bow your heads and clasp your hands. You don't have to close your eyes, but if you feel it helps, go for it. All hail the Dippy Dog. Yes, thank you. But please, no more super chats. Dear Relaxus, please help to relax us. Help us to sit back, unwind, unstress, decompress, breathe easy, hang loose, cool off, loosen up, and simmer down. Please bless... excuse me. Fumbled that. Please bless us with mellow moods and chill vibes as we hang out, shoot the shit, and just straight kick it. Give us the strength to ignore politics, drama, and the tragedies of our modern world, and grant us the serenity to forgive those on social media who post things that make us triggered, upset, and emotionally compromised. And as always, help me to wish harmony to those who wish harm on me. Amen. Let's finish off our prayer by doing some square breathing. This is when you inhale and outhale at similar intervals. We're going to breathe in through our nose and out through our mouth, and we're going to do a count of eight. If you can't breathe through your nose, using your mouth is fine too. Starting off, in through the nose. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and out through the mouth. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Once more, in through the nose. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And out through the mouth. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. straight to the desktop. I don't want to waste any time today. I want to get this game started. No wasting time today. Today I'm not in the mood for time wasting. I don't know about you guys. The music stop? Oh, there it goes. Alright. Vacation from Miitopia. That's the name of this track. And now to open my eyes and gaze upon... gaze verily upon my desktop, where I'm sure, truly, nothing bad awaits me. Oh, fuck! AI-generated images of Sonic the Hedgehog. Well, at least there's only three of them. It'll be a lot quicker today when there's only three. I mean, I can't just put all of these in the recycling bin. Surely they won't get along. I have no choice. I'll have to categorize them, I guess.
$5 from Saito Kiriku TM. I don't know how to breathe anymore. Help.
I don't know if I could help anybody with that. Not knowing how to breathe would be a very serious problem, but, you know, just remind yourself. Even lowly creatures can do it. I mean, you know, what kind of intelligence could a spider possibly have compared to you? Or an ant? Ants are really fucking dumb. An ant can breathe? Why can't you? Just pretend you're an ant. Close your eyes and pretend you're an ant. And then the breathing will come naturally. I do have to categorize these Sonics, though. I bet if we do it quick, we can get it over with. So let's bang this and get it over with. First Sonic of the day. This is great. I love this. I love this Sonic. It's pretty weird. Are you sure ants breathe? Don't they have to? Don't all animals need oxygen? I vaguely remember being a child and looking at an illustration in a book about insects. Where, you know, like an insect is kind of like bifurcated and you can see all of their organs. And I think I remember them having lungs. I think that's a real thing. Do insects have lungs? Insects don't have lungs. And their blood doesn't carry oxygen. Oh my gosh. Insect cells get oxygen via a direct link to the air outside. A network of tubes, called the trachea, let oxygen reach cells deep within the insect. So, the truth is somewhere in the middle, I guess? It does seem like they do... Let me show you guys what I'm looking at. This is what I'm reading right here. It looks like they do need oxygen. So they breathe, in a sense, they're just not breathing with lungs. But once again... I guess that doesn't necessarily make my example incorrect. You can still learn to breathe by pretending to be an ant. Although, I guess you wouldn't be breathing like an ant. Because I guess maybe they just take the air in through their pores? Interesting. No, wait. The other thing. Tedious. This is a very... this is a very lumpy touch, Sonic. I think there's a YouTuber who... there's a YouTuber called Lumpy Touch who makes artwork that's very reminiscent of this. Would you guys say this is a Lumpy Touch Sonic? It's ugly Sonic. Oh, I think this Sonic is... Even this Sonic... is slightly more attractive than ugly Sonic.
Curtis Fountain, fun fact. Tardigrades can survive in extreme temp environments and can survive in a total vacuum.
Really? Tardigrades, those are those tiny, 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 tiny little things, right? Like almost microscopic? I think I know what you're talking about. Weird. Weird Sonic is weird. In with the weird boys he goes. I think all of these Sonics are also easy to categorize, so that'll pick things up a bit. Here we have a cool Sonic, unequivocally, unquestionably. Anyone would look at this image and say it's cool. Might be one of the coolest Sonics I've seen. Sonic absolutely dripped out. He's dripped. Sonic is dripping with drip.
$5 from Mastrovolt 992.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, Max. Work sucks and I hate it.
No, I'm
Thank
sorry.
You for making it bearable. Your streams help out a lot.
Oh, no problem, bud. I'm glad to help. I'm sorry that your work sucks, but work sucks for everybody these days. Remember, everyone is miserable. No one is happy. And that'll make you feel better for some reason. That should make you feel better. If it doesn't make you feel better, maybe you're just not thinking about it hard enough. Cool Sonic. Last but not least, a very adorable image. Sonic engaging with friendship. And the friend in this image? Why, Mickey Mouse, of course. I love it. I'm not sure what he's drinking. Guess this is like one of those LA beaches. I don't know. Just chilling with Mickey. Just hanging out. Where's Sonic's other foot at? Yeah, it does kind of look like he only has one foot. You'd think it would be kind of like popping out down here a little bit, and it is not. It is just gone. It is just truly gone. And that's not great. But what do we always say about Sonic engaging in friendship? It's cute. It's adorable. It's always cute. I don't know what this thing down here is. What does that look like to you guys? This part up here looks like a bicycle helmet. This part down here kind of looks like some kind of a speaker. I don't know. I don't know if this is a friendship that could work. I don't know if Sonic and Mickey Mouse would be compatible as friends. Although I've seen a lot of people argue about whether or not Mickey Mouse even has a personality. And I think some of his
$11 from the pal Polly. Max, this is an extremely important question. Would you smash Cherry from Pee-wee's Playhouse?
No, I would just sit on it.
$5 from Old Snippers. Just saw old fan art you did of Steven Universe looking more Jewish. And another of a large black rose quartz. Good to know you were always talented.
Behave yourself.
$5 from Zog Chones. What is your opinion on geese? Hong Kong.
I've heard they're disgusting. I've heard they're, like, vicious and angry, and they'll bite you. You know? New TTS voice when? Soon. I don't have any experience with geese, but I've heard that they slobber, they're always drooling, and if you get near them, they'll attack you and bite you and stuff. So I wouldn't say I'm pro-geese. I've heard there's a goose game that's very popular. I don't know what it's called. I think it might be just entirely untitled. But you know what? I'll say I'm not pro-geese, but I'm also not anti-geese. You know, the geese can go on, they can go live their lives. As long as they're not bothering me. Gosh, I wish this shirt was a tank top, but it's not! It has sleeves! I'll have to deal. Cute. Cute Sonic. In with the cute boys it goes. And look at this! Spick and span, neat, clean, tidy, and trim. So satisfying to clean up, and when you're feeling satisfied, you're feeling relaxed. I installed this, right? Yes. Once again, I did not bother opening the game today to test to make sure if it worked. And I'm playing fire when I do that, but I couldn't be bothered. Grab a controller! Oh! Fine. That means I'm gonna have to spend a few minutes fiddling with controller settings. This game needs a controller for best experience. Device not supported? This game has support for some controllers, but not your device? What? Why? Grab an Xbox controller, a DualSense controller, or really any kind of controller-looking device. Well, not any kind, obviously! That can connect to your PC. Guys, can I do this with keyboard and mouse? Does it really matter?
$5 from Sen. Max, this game works with keyboard slash mouse. It's my favorite game of all time.
Wow, that's high praise. You can take... Yes, you can take the keyboard. It'll be difficult. Alright, keyboard and mouse it is. This is gonna be an experiment, I suppose. Device not supported, it says. Grab any controller! Device not supported! Outer Wilds is best experience with a gamepad. Fuck you! It's best experience with a gamepad, just not yours.
Sauce. This new text-to-speech voice is horrible. I'm Miss Plankton and I am out here mourning the loss of Planky Wanky. Crying and crapping, not gonna lie.
Do not cry and crap at the same time. It's very undignified. Finish your crap before you start to cry. Finish your cry before you start to crap. Best experience with a gamepad. Well, I guess we'll find out. I'm gonna go with negative 8.4 dB. Best experience with a gamepad, just not fucking yours. Enter profile name. And if I had my Gwimbly gun on me right now! Adjust the slider until the image on the left is barely visible. I'm just gonna leave it where it was. New expedition. Good luck, Max. You're gonna need it. Press E to wake up. Well, I've been trying. Am I meant to walk automatically? I'm not pressing any buttons right now. Is this normal? Do I walk automatically and at a weird angle? I'm not touching anything. Unplug your controller. It's not plugged in. It's not plugged in. It's connected to Bluetooth and I can't turn it off because it doesn't have an off button. Shoot. Oh man, fuck me in the ass. Fuck me in the ass with a dick that has AIDS. Quit to main menu. All progress will be lost. Yes. Sorry, Gwimbly. Okay, what can I do? I can open up Bluetooth and disconnect the device. And see if that helps. This is it. Remove device. And that, yep, it's off. Okay, good. Try this again. Whoever is bugging me on Discord, will you kindly pipe the fuck down? Outer Wilds is best experience with a gamepad? Not here, it's not. Kindly pipe the fuck down. Kindly. I'm asking kindly. Means you have to do it. This game is apparently important to so many people, and my experience is gonna be awful. But, you know? This, you know what? There's a lesson to be learned here. I always open the game to make sure it works. And if I had opened the game to make sure that it worked before I played today, this wouldn't have happened. Because when you do need to use a controller, you often need to set it up first. There we go.
$5 from Curtis Fountain. Have you gone into your Steam settings and turned on all the controller compatibilities?
Maybe I haven't. Hey, bud. Making s'mores? Talk to Slate. There's our pilot, back from your pre-launch campout under the stars, I see. Ooh, I don't like your face. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be prejudiced, it's not something I'm used to. So it's launch day, eh? Seems like only yesterday you joined the space program, and suddenly here you are, leaving on your first solo voyage. What do you say, ready to get this beauty off the ground? It's all fueled up and ready to go. I'm ready if you are? Are you kidding? Of course I'm ready. It's finally time to test the new landing hydraulics with a pilot instead of the autoflight system. Speaking of pilots, make sure you don't crash the ship the first time you put it down, you hear? Anyway, you'll need to get the launch codes from Hornfels at the observatory before you can lift off. Just bring those here once you've said your goodbyes or whatever. Okay. There's something somewhere called an observatory that I guess I need to find. Are you Hornfels? Who are you? Mika! Ooh, you're tiny! You're a tiny little thing! Are you a child? Are you a child? Are you a tiny little person?
$5 from Neo Grimes 543. This game changed my view of the universe while simultaneously giving me crippling existential dread.
Oh no.
Changed my life forever. Not exaggerating.
I don't think I like the sound of having my view of the universe changed. Or getting crippling existential dread. I don't like either of those things. Horizontal thrust. Ooh. Am I supposed to be able to control this well? Down up thrust control. It's a little loud for me, not for you guys. Left shift. Yes! Liftoff! That's kind of fun. What's your deal? Oh my gosh, it is, for me, very loud. There we go. Mika. Wow, that was just like the time the external fuel tanks exploded on re-entry. You'll be okay flying the big one, right? I don't know. Apparently I'm supposed to have a controller that I don't have. I hope that's okay. Is that the big one? Porphy. Heyo, hatchling. I hear you're leaving us to seek adventure amongst the stars. When you return, let's you, me, and Gassan open up a bottle of the good stuff. I'm only seeking adventures amongst one star, actually. Other stars are too far away. Or, the good stuff is less delicious sap wine and more daunting digestive challenge. An iron stomach is the mark of a true Harthian, my friend. Our hardy hunter-gatherer lifestyle stems from trial and error. By which I mean our ancestors survived eating a lot of bad things. Coolsies. I don't know if I want to talk to everyone. Outer Wilds Ventures presents postcards from orbit. You look old. Are you an old man?
You're actually blasting off on that thing, huh?
I really don't explode as often anymore. I'm told my odds of survival aren't statistically quite high.
All I know is between the space program and Mika's model rockets, things seem to burn to the ground around here more than they used to.
What are you looking at? There ain't nothing. You just looking at the geyser? So it's launch day, huh? Hal's gonna miss you. Speaking of launch day, I was thinking about it, and the platform those ships launch from is getting old. Isn't it about time you built a new, less flammable one? That big tree in the village would be the perfect choice. I wouldn't mind helping out the space program, just say the word. God, Launch pad is flammable? That sounds like bad news. Ha! You didn't realize that? Don't worry, it's held up with all the rockets so far. Or with all the launches so far. Oh, I slipped a different word in there. It'll definitely be fine for yours. Probably. Can I go in there? No. Gneese. Hello there, Space Cadet. I hear you're leaving the crater today. If you meet any of the other travelers up there, remind them to take proper care of their instruments, won't you? Where's the observatory? That's right, I was looking for that. It's questions like that what make us worried about you going up into space on your own, you know? The observatory is up the path behind the waterfall. There are a couple of signs marking the way, but really, you just gotta keep going and then hook a right when you get to the Zero-G cave. Probably can't go in there. I don't see a waterfall. We have a geyser. Of course, I could just follow the sign. Hey, lads. Tephra. Are you more children? I don't know. You know, I don't mean to be offensive to whatever race of aliens you are, but I'm having difficulty discerning between the children and the adults. Hello, astronaut. Well, if it isn't my favorite troublemaker, I'm gonna say you're a child. We wanted to play hide-and-seek, but Moraine won't let us borrow their signal scope because it's really delicate and not supposed to be thrown around like that. Hey, can we use your signal scope? Can we? Can we, please? We'll even let you be it. No. Oh, really? But we can't play without a signal scope. Play with us later, okay? Are you the mom? Are you this young man's mother? No, you don't want to talk to me. Waiting for your husband to get back. He went out for cigarettes, right? I know how it is. There's the waterfall! There it is. Fishing rhyme, singing helps me pass the time. You're leaving the crater? Guess we'll all be a little busier without you around to lend a hand. That big water planet, Giants Deep, that's where I'd go. Why's that? One time, after the rest of the village had left to sleep and it was just the two of us sitting around the campfire, Gabbro told me about their first trip to Giants Deep. They landed their ship,
10 euros from Northern 94. Hi Max, I'm so happy you're playing this. Was planning to super chat and suggested, take your time and relax. Don't worry about looking dumb. It will be super fun for us, even if you take it slow.
You know, that's what you say. First of all, appreciate the super chat. That's what you say. And yet, when I am dumb in a video game and I can't figure out what to do, I look at the chat and you guys are all angry at me. Because to you, it's just so damn obvious. Well, you know what? Maybe it ain't obvious to me, pal. They landed their- thank you for the super chat, though. They landed their ship easily enough in the waves, but couldn't see too far down. On account of how murky the water was, I guess. Too dark. Gabbro wants to see what lay beneath the surface, so they decided to travel deeper. They traveled down and down, but suddenly, Gabbro couldn't go any further. Tell me more. I will! I was just pausing dramatically. As though exercising a will of its own, the water was refusing- for fart's sake.
Badass boy. Hey friends. Hope you had a good week. Make sure you sleep in this weekend, love you.
I will sleep in this week. The water was refusing to let Gabbro go any deeper. It held Gabbro back, almost as if it were trying to protect them from something. And then, in the terrible darkness, Gabbro saw it. The tentacle of some hideous beast. Ah! I mean, that's what Gabbro said anyway. Whatever it was, it freaked Gabbro out pretty good. Keep referring to him in the third person. Everyone wants to hear new stories at the village campfire, you know? Make sure you bring some back with you. Okay. If I come up with any, I'll let you know. Pretty wiggly looking waterfall. So this game is going to give me an existential crisis, huh? Danger. Inside this fence is a pocket of ghost matter, a strange and dangerous substance that's invisible to the naked eyes. The good news is that you can detect ghost matter with a camera. I mean, it all seems pretty lighthearted so far. You know, there's like cute aliens everywhere. With, you know, big cute eyes, big adorable eyes, and they all seem pretty friendly. And this world is pretty cartoony and silly. Moving through ghost matter is uniquely painful and will probably kill you. That's not so cute. Don't complain to me if you hurt yourself fooling around, Hornfels. I don't know why it's giving me that take snapshot graphic twice, but... Am I photographing orbs? Am I getting into orbs right now? I don't know. I don't know if this is anything. This is probably nothing. What's up, kid? You're definitely a kid.
Hi, astronaut! You know the patch of ghost matter inside this fence? Gassan said it used to be bigger than when they were hatchling. Because ghost matter evaporates. It just takes a super long time to go away. I hope there's still ghost matter in the village when I'm grown up. Ghost matter is awesome.
$5 from Chocolate Gamer 12. This game looks amazing. Also, are you going to be making any more brain dump episodes? You're the best.
I don't know about brain dump. Brain dump might be a pretty big dead end at this point. Ghost matter is super cool.
Yeah, I heard touching it hurts so bad you feel like your whole hand's on fire. Try not to walk into space, okay? That sounds bad and painful.
Okay, I won't walk into space. Is this the observatory? I saw smoke coming from Young Bark Crater up north and figured I should go check it out. You can use the scout launcher, just please don't break it while I'm gone. The southern accent is perfect. Yeah, these are all striking me as some pretty southern characters, the way they're dressed. They're all dressed like a bunch of alien hillbillies. North, Young Bark Crater. That's all the words that are on this big piece of paper with all the little scratches on it? Alright. Use scout launcher. Retrieve scout. Oh, it moves. It's moving. Rotate camera. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're on like a spherical planet, like Mario Galaxy style. Spherical planet? Make like footage if I just click it really fast. Animation is the photographic frame-by-frame process where pictures are shown together in sequence to create the illusion of movement. Still looking for that observatory. Hello. Talk to Moraine. Hmm? Oh, hello, astronaut. Am I not an alien? Is that why they're calling me astronaut? If I were to see myself, would I be a human or something? This is good weather for your launch, right? That's lucky. What are you up to? I'm using my signal scope to pick up sounds from distant planets. It's set to the Outer Wilds Ventures frequency, so I can pick up the Traveler's music. Last night I'd heard Rybeck's banjo coming from Brittle Hollow. I hope that means they're safe. I can hear different planets, too. It depends on what time of day or night it is, since different planets are in the sky at different times. Signal scopes are cool. Equip signal scope? I have one. I can equip. Zoom in. Alright, I mean, I might just call this a telescope. I'm not hearing a whole lot.
$9.99 from Rosemary Sows. Hi, Max.
Hello.
Quick question about Fanart Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Do you personally pick out which pieces go in, or do you have mods do it?
I do it.
I drew like 5 of the pieces you showed today, and it made my year.
Oh, yeah. I just picked them arbitrary, so if I used five of yours, that was just a coincidence. You got lucky. You got lucky, pal. But congratulations on your luck. Everybody deserves to get lucky once in a while, right? Can I get up there? Nope. Oh, cleared that jerk. Cleared that asshole. Zero G cave. And the observatory is that way? Hey, come say hi to your old flight coach before your launch. I've got zero G training set up if you want a refresher. That might be useful. Hey, I thought I might see you before the big launch. Nerves getting the better of you? I'm a little nervous, yeah. I guess I'm launching somewhere. Good, everyone should be a bit nervous going into space. I got cocky during my first flight, and I nearly put a new crater in the moon. Still, I was never as green as you. Hey, I've gotten better! Think so, do you? Feel like proving it to your old flight coach? There's a satellite, which is definitely not just a piece of broken mining equipment, set up down in the Zero-G cave and in need of repairs. If you're looking for a little last-minute zero-G practice, head down the lift and into the cave. Or don't, so long as you're confident you can make the ship repairs in space. One repaired satellite coming up. Cool, get to it, and try not to concuss yourself right before your first step. Okay, lift. There's stars in here.
The stars at night are dull and dim. Whenever they happen to be over dumb old Texas.
I wouldn't call this a zero G cave. Just kind of like a reduced G cave. A slightly less G cave. But they're still G.
$5 from Mr. J Sandwich.
J Sandwich.
Happy to see you playing this. I wish I could remove my memory of it to discover everything and play it again. I got over phobias playing it.
You got over phobias? Interesting. Everybody is saying this game is very existential. Fuck. I just bricked myself. No. God. I can't get out. Oh, fart me. Every damn time. I don't know if there's any... Oh, hey! I don't know if there's any streamer who does that more consistently than me. Zero G cave. So I jump up. I have to get up there. I can't jump that high, though. What now? Suit up. Hey, there we go. Left control, left shift, up and down thrust.
$9.99 from Little Teviant. Hi, bald boy. I gotta get back to work. Kisses.
Mwah! Kisses for all of you. Everybody gets kisses today.
Zero G cave. Fuck yeah, I have a jetpack! Oh, that's so cool. Every game should give you a damn jetpack. Now, just for reference, one super chatter said that this game gave them existential dread. Another super chatter said this game cured their existential dread. Interesting. I hope I have a good experience with it. Hey, hey! Nice of you to drop down. Getting some zero-G time in. So you're going in there, in the cave. What? No, I'm fine. Great. Great and fine. You don't look fine. Well, you know, I hate that cave, so I don't know why you're making me talk about it. Fwech. Now I've got hand sweats. Okay, shift. Shift is up. Control is down. Yeah, blast off. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me around again to find I'm not the man that think I am at home. Oh no, oh no. I'm a rocket man. Rocket man. Burning out his fuse out here alone. This game's gonna finally turn me into a rocket man. I can feel it. 0 of 3 repaired. Okay, now I feel like I'm in 0G. Okay. Oh god. Oh no. Oh, this game's gonna make me dizzy, isn't it? How do I stop? Does anybody know how you stop in space? Press to lock on. Gotcha. Fuck, how do I stop? Come on. Okay, good. Okay. Okay. There's one. That way. This way. There's another one over here. Stop! 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 How do I stop? R to roll? What does that do? I don't know what that means. No, I'm getting farther away from it. Okay, slow down. Cool your jets, Buster Brown. Literally. Literally cool your fucking jets. Lock on. Hit E to fix. Okay, that's good. One more. Where is the last one? Where do the last one be? It's too dark in here. Can't see anything. You know, games always want to be like, turn down the slider until the image on the left is barely visible. And I'm just like, but then I won't be able to see anything. I won't be able to see anything then. In there? Let's try in there. Yeah, here we go. Hold to match velocity? Hold space to match velocity. Does that basically just mean stop? Yeah, I guess so. Alright, well, that makes it a hell of a lot easier. Space to match velocity. Training simulation complete. Now how do I get out of here? That way? That looks right. I'm a rocket man. Ow, whoa, wow, 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 wow. Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Rocket man. I'm burning out his fuse out here alone. Can't wait to be a rocket man. Can't wait to blast off. Okay, this was the way I came in. Yeah. I used the elevator. How are you feeling, bub? I did that thing. Nicely done! Of course, it'll be a little more stressful when you're hurtling through space. Just remember, you're training and try not to hit anything big. I can see you're itching to get off this rock, so go get the launch codes from the observatory and get out of here already. Best of luck out there. And hey, try to avoid getting yourself killed now that you've put so much time into training you. Since I've put so much time into training you, got it? You trained me? That was you? You know you are missing an eyeball? Did you know that? Now, which way is the observatory? I came up this way, so I guess observatory is this way. Sign is pointing that way. man, I can't wait to see if this game will give me existential dread or cure my existential dread. Of course, I've already got a fair share of existential dread, so maybe if it gives me existential dread, then I'll have twice as much. Oh boy! Hey, hey, it's my favorite astronaut. Launch day at last, huh, buddy? It's the translator tool's inaugural flight, too. I'm so excited, it's making me nervous. Or did he say nauseous? Just think, you'll be able to translate any Nomai text you want. Anywhere you are. The two of us put a lot of hours into inventing that tool, so don't break it, okay? Ha ha. Oh, geez. Do not break it. Ugh. Ignore me, okay? I'm just nervous, and I'm not even the one going into space. How are you feeling? I'm terrified. Oh, don't let me make you nervous. You've been training for this day since we were hatchlings, remember? You'll do great, I promise. So what's the dirt? You here to see the new Nomai statue? I'm just here for the launch codes. Yeah, I get that you're dying to head out into space. But seriously, you've got to see the statue before you go. It's an amazing find! Makes me wish we could see what a real-life Nomai looks like, but I guess this is as close as we'll ever get. Check it out. Looks like they had fur. Fur is weird. This is the first fully intact statue we've ever found, you know. And for how old it is, it's in great shape. Ah, geez, I got a little carried away there. Go on, have a ship to launch. Take care of yourself out there, you hear? This is the statue? This remarkably intact statue was carved by the Nomai, an ancient species who dwelled in our solar system thousands of years ago. The statue provides us with our most detailed look yet at the Nomai who appear to have been covered with a layer of fur. Note the decorative jewelry that has been carved as part of the antlers. Although their artifacts and structures have been found on almost every planet in the solar system, we still have no idea where this species came from or what happened to them. Coolsies. Big thanks to these additional founding members of Outer Wilds Ventures, without whom we would never have gotten off the ground. Matthew Steinhauer. I think those are people from the Patreon. Those are people, those are the Kickstarter supporters. Wiles Ventures, Timber Hearth's first and only space program.
$5 from Zaki. Hi, Maxi. If you were an astronomer, you'd be in charge of the Hubba Hubba telescope. Wink, wink.
Flattery will get you everywhere, darling. Feldspar was the first Hearthian to be intentionally launched into space. They completed the first orbit around Timber Hearth and later made the first of what would be many landings on our moon, the Adler Rock.
Flattery will get you everywhere. Oh my, oh yes, oh my!
I don't know if I want to look at all this. Ooh, weird fish. This crystal was taken from a Nomai ruin on Brittle Hollow. It seems to create a local gravity distortion and was most likely used to traverse steep surfaces. Try it out. Ooh. No way. What? Oh my god. That's trippy. I guess I am an alien. I do have the blue hands that everybody else has. Will I fall if I get too far away from the crystal? How does this work? Yep. Yes.
Yes.
When there is crystal on wall, I can walk on that wall. Interesting. It would be wise to remember that. I already went that way. The strange rock moving around in this grotto appears to react to conscious observation. The level-headed among us realize there must be some sort of optical illusion at play. But Gabbro claims the rock exists in all possible states until it is observed. Whatever that means. Whatever is actually happening, both sides of this debate agree the effect is extremely creepy. so it moves when I'm not looking at it? Yep. But I have to look at it for it to move, and then it'll be there. And then it's there. And then it's there. But how do I send it back there? I guess that's how.
Interesting.
Bum 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 bum. Ba 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 boom. Boom boom boom. Let's just play Among Us. Let's play Amoogus. Hello. Are you gonna give me the damn codes? You are Hornfels. So I hope you have them.
There you are. I just finished pre-flight observations, and local conditions are good. Time to get our newest astronaut off the ground! And you'll be our first astronaut ever equipped with a Nomai translator tool. I confess, I've been giddy all day long just thinking about it. We're better equipped than ever to unravel the mysteries of the Nomai. You and Hal should be very proud of your work.
Do I know who Hal is?
Tell me, what's your plan once you're in space?
I'm going to learn more about the Nomai, meet up with the other travelers. I want to go somewhere no one's gone before. I think I'll start with something small. I don't know. I'm gonna wing it. I'll probably wing it.
Planning to follow in the footsteps of Feldspar and the great Outer Wilds Ventures traditions, are you? I might have guessed. Bully! Well, see if you can't put that translator tool of yours to good use while you're out there. Well then, looks like all that's left is to send you off. All in all, it's a fine day for a launch.
I'm ready to get off this rock, or I'm ready to die in space.
I'm not one for superstition, but isn't that kind of unlucky to say before launch?
No, it would be unlucky if I said break a leg. That would be unlucky. For some reason.
At any rate, here are the launch codes. Try not to worry about too much. Our ships are every bit as safe as Slate could be persuaded to make them. Best of luck out there. Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Okay, codes received. New map. Okay, I am on Tiny Planet. Or actually, I guess it's not that much smaller than the other planets. There's one big planet called Giant's Deep. There's a sun. Two planets called the Hourglass Twins, a planet called Brittle Hollow, and something called the Dark Bramble. Ooh. Alright. Now, do I just go back to the start? Just go all the way back to the start now? I guess so. All the way back to the start it is. Nope, not that way. That's the weird rock that moves when you stop looking at it. This way. Oh no! Hello! What are you looking at me for? Buddy, you like what you see? You fucking like what you see? Was that everything I did today? Yeah, I did all that. Did you just absorb my memories? Why did you do that? That was everything that I was doing. That was like footage of everything I was doing, right? I think it was. Let me read this again. This remarkably intact statue was carved by the Nomai, an ancient species who dwelled in our solar system thousands of years ago. The statue provides us with our most detailed look yet at the Nomai, who appear to have been covered with a layer of fur. So just, it's an ancient species with fur. Nothing about them stealing your memories. Although their artifacts and structures have been found on almost every planet in the solar system, we still have no idea where this species came from or what happened to them. Okay. Hey. Did you get a good look at that Nomai statue? The statue was glowing. Why was it glowing?
Whoa, whoa. The statue was doing what? So its eyes opened, and then you saw images from your own memories and glowing lights flying around? You mean like a hallucination? Listen, no offense, but are you sure you're okay to launch, like, medically speaking?
You know what? Don't worry about it.
Maybe you should sit down for a bit and take it easy. I'd hate for anything bad to happen if you tried to launch while you're not feeling great. But hey, when you are ready, you can make the most of our translator tool. I can't believe it's all grown up and leaving for space already. For real though, I'm glad you're the one carrying it and not like Raybeck, whoever that is. They'd fall on it for sure. Say, if you want to do a short trip to just get your space legs under control, you should check out the ruins on the Addle Rock. I'd love to learn what those are. Good luck and safe flying. Wolf, I almost fell.
Did I take fall damage? Let's not find out. I don't want to lose progress. Let's not find out just yet. The music is very relaxing. This might be a good game for Relax with Max with this music.
Hello, astronaut. Are you going into space today? Are you going into space and never coming back like Feldspar did?
That's pretty disturbing.
But Hornfell says no one knows what happened to Feldspar. Hornfell says they got lost in space, even though they were the best pilot ever. You're not as good as Feldspar, so you should be really careful not to get lost.
Whoop! Into space we go. I can't wait to blast off as a rocket man. Hey, bud, I got the codes. Oh, so that was like a nice little shortcut that we took over there.
Looks like you're ready for takeoff. The excitement of a launch is full and all, is fun and all, but I can't wait to get back to working on the new ship. We're working on fixing the autopilot's avoidance system for this one. Sorry.
Enter launch codes. Away we go! Play some dramatic astronaut music, or... Ooh, is this it? Is this... Oh, I don't want this to be it! What a piece of junk! To quote Luke Skywalker. Alright, let's get this over with. I wanted a cool, like, space shuttle-looking thing. This is not cool. This is not cool. Suit up, I'll take this. Do I need it? You know what? I won't take that. I don't know if I need it. I'll take that when I need it. Buckle up. View ship log. View entries. Village, the one and only Harthian village, as well as the main source of explosions on this planet. The Nomai statues in the observatory opened its eyes and looked at me. I saw strange glowing lights, and my own memories flashed before my eyes. Alright, so these are just like a mission, a task log. A cave at the very center of Timber Hearth used by Outer Wilds Ventures to train new astronauts. I successfully repaired another satellite for Gassan. Leave ship. Okay. There's one of those crystals. Okay. Proceed to lift off. Hold shift L for lift off. Oh wait, lift off landing camera. So, I hold this for... Okay, I'm guessing I use this to land if I want a soft landing. So, I guess I just hit shift. Yeah. Set sail for adventure. Oh my gosh. Holy fuck. That was fast. I'm already in space. You gotta be kidding me. Oof. Okay, okay. I wish I could hit space to go up instead of shift. Because you already use it to jump, but... But space is used to... To match velocity. And stop. Stop where I am. Okay, Oh, whoa, no, no, stop, no, I'm gonna crash, no, up, 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 okay, 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 y'all be outer wildin. I just want to look at the planet, I don't want to land on it. But I guess if you stop while you're too close to it, gravity takes over? I just want to look around though. There's a little moon, I could go to the moon! Yep, yep, I cannot stop. I cannot stop. No, you know what? That might not be a moon. That might be far away. I cannot stop in space. Because if you stop in space, something just grabs you. Velocity. Excuse me, velocity. Velocity matched. So now. Now maybe what's going on is the planets are moving? Know if, I guess it's gonna be hard to tell if I'm moving or if the planets are moving, because I'm guessing the planets are also moving as well. Let's try whatever that is. Not Giant's Deep. We don't want to go to Giant's Deep right away. View map, tab. I am there, ooh, okay, I am there. Timber Hearth. Where I came from, Giant's Deep, Brittle Hollow, Dark Bramble. It looks like I'm drifting out of the universe. Where do I want to go first? The Hourglass Twins. We could try out the Hourglass Twins. Is that them right there? Hollow's Lantern, no. Ash Twin. An Ember Twin. I think that's them. Let's see if we can move on forward to getting there. Is this game pretty open? Like, is there a place that I'm supposed to go, or what? I don't really, I'm having a hard time recalling if it gave me like a mission or anything. They just said, you know, you're going in space, you're launching. I don't know. You can go anywhere. This is a puzzle game. We cannot say. It's very open. It's more comparable to Myst than anything else. Okay, come on. Come on. Come on. I feel like I'm getting farther away from it. Come on! I'm gonna drift in blackness forever because I can't get any closer to anything. Come on.
$5 from Neo Grimes 533. Hey, this game is open. Do what you want and explore, not linear.
Well, it looks like what I'll be doing is just drifting endlessly in an infinite black void because I can't. I'm not getting any closer to this thing that I'm trying to get closer to. Maybe if I match velocity first, do this. Do this first. Okay, now try. Hmm. 17 km, does that mean 17 kilometers away? But space is much bigger than kilometers, right? 15. Okay, I'm getting closer. Now I'm getting closer. 12. Don't get sucked into the fucking sun. Let's try not to get sucked into the sun today. 9. Come on. Come on. 10. Oh, now I'm getting farther away again. 11. Oh, for fart's sake! This isn't working. What do I do? What do I do? The game just wants me to entropy out into the void. But you guys keep saying, no, we're not gonna tell you what to do. You're supposed to figure it out on your own.
$5 from Mr. J. Sandwich. The universe is one big puzzle.
Really?
You have to figure out what to do by exploring the planets you visit. When you find something new, your ship logs it for you.
Cool. What is that? That's Giant's Deep. Yeah, I really am just drifting out into space. Try matching velocity again. Velocity matched. Is the idea that when you match velocity, you match the velocity of the thing that you're locked onto? So if I locked onto this and matched velocity, what would happen then? Velocity matched. Then I just have to do it again, because I keep drifting out of velocity?
$5 from Curtis Fountain. Use the ding dang autopilot.
I want to do it myself, $5
though. $5 from Neo Grimes 543. Autopilot X is your best friend.
You don't play a video game about flying a damn spaceship to turn on the autopilot, obviously. That. I want to know how to do it myself. I can get there. I just have to hold the button down for long enough. Am I getting closer again? What's the whole point? What is the point of this thing? Why even give the player controls if they're just supposed to use the autopilot?
$5 from Zaki. Max, can you cover your ears real quick?
No.
Hey everyone, Max told me in private that I was his favorite close person friend. Just thought I'd let you know.
No, not the sun. Not the sun! Not the sun! Not the sun! No, jeez! Oh, wait, whoa, whoa, whoa! Wait, 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 whoa! Hang on, hang on. Okay, we're close, we're close. Hang on, hang on. Come on, come on, no! Oh, no! No! Oh... Shit. I'm fucked. What is that? I see something. A comet? Aligning flight trajectory returning to solar system. The interloper.
$5 from Reeker VB. Autopilot is cringe and lame. Don't use it. It's completely optional. Have fun exploring. You'll figure out what to do.
Herm.
BTW.
Herm. Fucking Herm, my dude. Herm. I don't want to use the autopilot, but I also feel like I'm not getting any closer to figuring out how to fly my damn ship. What if I just go right into the sun? Firing retro rockets? Why are you doing that? What if I want to go into the sun? Brittle Hollow, Giant's Deep. I almost feel like maybe gravity should just not even be a factor at all. Because I don't know how I'm going to be able to manage moving around out here when everything is sucking me in.
$5 from Just Ank. Hey Max.
Hi.
I hope you're doing okay in that vast endless void of space where dreams and hope go to die by the way no one can hear you scream kisses, Baldy.
Dreams and hope also die right here on Earth. What are you talking about? Of course they do. You don't have to go to space for that. Match velocity. Matching velocity. Matching velocity. Oh shoot, it went around the other side of the damn sun. I have to fix something out. I can't just be fucking around in space forever. I can't. What is like the nearest thing I can go to? Giant's Deep. Okay, that. Space to match velocity. Getting closer. There we go. Giants Deep, here I come. It's crash land right on it. Hang on. Whoa, no, no, oh! Stop! Well, I'm out of ideas. Yeah, autopilot, I guess. It says engage autopilot, but where is the autopilot flying me? Stage 1, aligning flight trajectory. Stage 2, accelerating towards destination. Okay, well, I figured out that much. Is the idea that I can kind of use the autopilot to teach me? Firing retro rockets. Use it to teach me kind of the skills of how I navigate? Oh, that's beautiful. Autopilot complete. Well, I'm not there yet. C to go into landing mode? Cockpit view. Where did it go? Oh, wait, there it is. Okay, okay. Ooh, whoa. Am I landing? I think I landed in the ocean. Yep. I'm in the ocean. Ooh, dang. This place is scary. That might be a good place to land. Oh, no! My window! I cracked my damn window. I'm gonna get sucked out. Oh, no. Oh, no. What's happening? The island is gone. Okay, okay. This is a fucking shit show. I wasn't expecting to embarrass myself this much today. Is there anything to land on this planet? It's just water and tornadoes? Max downloaded the wrong Starfield game. Considering nobody liked Starfield, I'm guessing this is probably better. Considering nobody likes Starfield and I've heard nothing but good things about this, I'm gonna say this is better. Okay, okay. This might be better with a gamepad, might be better with a controller. We can play this again. We can do multiple streams of this. Get my controller ready for next time. Okay, land. Please just land. There. Okay. All right. Open hatch. Okay. E, repair landing gear.
$5 from Stone underscore Yoshi.
Stuck.
3. I was recently watching your first YouTube stream, and you mentioned something about doing a you laugh you lose. What happened with that?
Turning on sticky keys. What I've learned about you laugh you lose is I don't understand how all the content creators who do you laugh you lose find playlists that are good. Because if you search You Laugh, You Lose playlist on Google, you don't really find anything. Also, I'm literally stuck. I'm fucking borked again. I might be in trouble. I might have to go back inside. Is there any way to reset? Because I'm really stuck. I'm really stuck. Oh my gosh, this game is really cool looking. I love the like the stormy waves and then the tornadoes in the background. It looks nice. You forgot your jetpack, brother? Okay, but I also can't walk or move or jump or do anything. How do I reset? Oh no. Oh no! Oh fuck no! Fuck no! Alright, I guess we're fine. I guess that's nothing. We just go into the eye of the storm real quick. Ah, gee. Oh wow, god. Hey! Well, I guess that might have been fortuitous then. This is my jetpack? Yeah. Where am I? Let's try going out again. I just want to find some solid damn ground. Oh, bleh, 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 bleh. Rising tide. Rising tide. Okay, just let me get out of the damn water. Oh boy, there's somebody! I can't get to him. Hello, can I talk? Gabbro. I've heard your name a lot.
Nice, it's you. Good to see you made it here in one piece. The first solo launch is a doozy, isn't it? So hey, don't laugh, but I think I might have some kind of spiritual experience with a rock shaped like a face.
Me too. I mean, I wouldn't call it spiritual, I would call it strange. Of course, I also don't know how I would define spiritual experience. I guess that could be a lot of things.
You're saying a spiritual experience is the way that you interpret an experience, maybe. You're saying the statue I brought to the museum started glowing at you? Yeah, sounds about right.
One minute I'm standing on an island looking at a Nomai sculpture on the beach, and the next thing I know, it's looking back at me, glowing. It replays everything I've just done. Like it's been watching me through my own eyes, you know? And then suddenly it stops, and everything's normal again.
Didn't seem bad, just weird. We were the only ones who saw that happen.
I tried radioing Hornfels and asking them about it, but they told me I might have just nodded off out here and gotten confused. Then we talked about dreams until Hornfels told me to...
Whoop, 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 whoop!
What happened? What happened? What happened? What is this? What's going on?
Yeah, memories. Okay. Did I die? Is this the afterlife? This looks very afterlife-y.
Back at the beginning. But I still have the launch codes, that's good.
What just happened? I guess a storm on the planet killed me at a really bad time?
Well, that's no good.
Oh, hold up! You're going to want to get the launch codes from the observatory first. I already got them from the observatory, remember? Huh. Must be inhaling more fumes than I realized. That stuff is potent. Well, if you got the codes, I'm not gonna stop you. Good luck, and take care of that ship. Alright, I wanna try this again. I'm going to use the autopilot to see if it can kinda teach me how to fly by myself. I would love to get to the point where I don't need the autopilot. That over. Ooh, nope. Up, 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 up. Can I land anywhere on this planet? Could I just land in this big field down here if I wanted to? Let me try. Bonk.
$5 from Shujinko 2. Use the lines while locked on to align yourself with the planet. Accelerate to it. Then slow down so your velocity doesn't slingshot you out of orbit.
Use the lines while locked on to align yourself with the planet. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Fuck, I have this entire hemisphere of the planet all to myself. And walk around naked, jerk off on this tree, anything I want. I don't know why that's where my mind immediately goes, but I could if I wanted to and nobody could stop me. I could if I wanted to.
There's a forest. Let's see what's in that forest over there. Anything? Hello? I know what you people do in the tall trees. I saw what you did in the tall trees. Ooh. Found something. Look at this. This game rules. Charting stars again out by the radio tower. They're so bright out here. I only wish I were able to record them faster. Admittedly, I could use more patience. I get so engrossed in my work that sunrise becomes an unwelcome deadline. And daylight, a grating slog. Someday I'll have to study the mechanics of how time manages to slow to a syrupy crawl when I'm anticipating something. In the meantime, I've turned to Gabbro, our resident expert in leisurely whiling away the hours, who recommended the following. Gabbro's three foolproof steps for dozing off. 1. Light a nice cozy campfire and get comfortable. 2. Gaze deeply into the serene warmth. 3. Let time begin to slip away as you allow the flames to lull yourself into a peaceful slumber. This guy sounds like a lazy slacker. How are you going to get anything accomplished in life with that kind of attitude? Don't you want to accomplish anything? Don't you want to do anything bigger than yourself, Gabbro? If Gabbro knew I'd taken notes, they'd probably think I'd finally cracked, but I refuse to accept sass from an astronaut who deliberately burns their marshmallows. This is like No Man's Sky, except when you land on a planet, you actually find something. I can't believe it. Roast marshmallow. What's the point? What is the point? Move stick. Extend stick. You know, I always love a game that gives you the option to extend stick. Whoa, hey, whoa. No. Stop. Oh, shoot. Let's try that again. Gently now. Gently. No, stop! E, extinguish. Fuck, it's black. Try that again. I just want it brown, I don't want it black. But I also can't really see because the game is so dark. That's good. I'll eat that. Alright. Press C to doze off. What does that do? Wilfo, go lie down, bud. Wilfo's literally just licking a door. Wolfo, don't lick my door. You silly Billy. A counter is just timing as I'm asleep. Interesting. Wake up. This is new. This is interesting. Ooh, what is that? Is that an actual moon? I'm gonna go to the moon. Closed due to fire damage. The old radio tower, while an important landmark, is unfortunately closed thanks to the unsanctioned flight testing of an extremely powerful model rocket. While we hope to repair the radio tower in the future, all construction efforts are currently focused on the planned museum expansion at the observatory. Sincerest apologies, except to Slate and Mika, Hornfels, museum curator. Okay. Blip. Blip. I can't believe I went into that forest and I actually found something. I was just being goofy. I was just like, yeah, let's go in the woods. But then there was something in there. Let me tell you, that's how you make an open world game. There's just gotta be cool stuff everywhere. View ship logs. Gabbro's Island. Should I try going back to Gabbro's Island to have that conversation with him that was interrupted by my untimely demise? Gabbro was lounging in a hammock near the island's shore. Gabbro found a Nomai, it's got all the same letters, statue on another island. The statue's eyes started glowing, and Gabbro saw their fond memories flash before their eyes. Are these all sexless, genderless aliens? They don't have masculine pronouns? Statue's eyes started glowing, and Gabbro saw their memories flash before their eyes. There's more to explore here. Statue Island. One of the islands on Giant's Deep has a Nomai statue on the beach, just like the one Gabbro brought back to Timber Hearth. Okay. Let's try doing some more flying. Let's give this another crack. And where was that moon that I saw? Where was that moon? It's gotta be somewhere. It's gotta be somewhere around the planet, obviously. Ooh, what is that? That could be something. Oh, wait, there it is! The Addle Rock! That's kinda like the planet's moon? Match velocity. Velocity match, then I move towards it, yeah. Then I hit back. Okay, I'm getting the hang of this. Forward. But then right before I crash, I thrust in the opposite direction. Okay, what now? Now I'm gonna hit C to land. But oh gee. Okay, I might have a bit of trouble with landing. But I think I've landed somewhere? Perhaps upside down? Cockpit view. Yep, can't see a whole lot. Nope, I have not landed. And I'm upside down.
Yep, let's see if I can...
Okay. There we go. Okay. Alright, we've landed somewhere. Let's go do some exploring. Get my suit this time. Turn on my flashlight. This is honestly very similar to what I think I and a lot of people were expecting No Man's Sky to be like. Play recording. Chert's research notes. Property of Chert. This is an old crater. The neat thing here is that the composition of the samples I took from the impact site matches the composition of the ice on the outskirts of Dark Bramble. I'd posit the Addle Rock was hit with a piece of the planet that used to be where Dark Bramble now lies. To follow up on, maybe there are more fragments of the old planet Dark Bramble destroyed on other astral bodies in the solar system?
Interesting.
Refuel jetpack. Good. Oof. Oh my gosh, this planet is spinning. Look at that. It's probably not going to have as much gravity. Because it is tiny. So, I'm going to have to be careful. Thrust upward. Up. Oh my gosh, I have an oxygen meter. I'm slowly running out of oxygen when I'm out here. That's gonna be a problem. Oh, ooh, what is that over there? That is a different other planet. Okay, never mind. There's my shadow. Whoa, ooh, okay.
Can I just... Whoa. Oh, I went all the way around the planet already? Okay. Can I just jump into space without my ship? Let's see. I'm gonna try that out. So long, Terra Firma. Who needs you, right? Ha 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 ha! Oh. Yes. Oh, cool. What do I even need the ship for then? Let's try going over there. Just leave my ship on one planet, go to a different planet. Why not? Of course, I'm having some trouble getting there. Am I matching velocity or not? Come on. Oh, I might be screwed. I'm in trouble. I'm in trouble now. 50% fuel remaining. Yep, I'm in trouble. This was a mistake. I see that now. Oops. Come on. Am I getting close? I'm not getting closer. And I'm not matching velocity either. Wait a minute. Yes. Come on. No. Match velocity. Go. I might have to watch a YouTube video on how to navigate in space in this game. Because sometimes it just seems like the matching of velocity doesn't do a whole lot. 3 minutes oxygen remaining. That's bad. Yep, that's bad. And also, bonk. Ow! Shit! Bonk. Are we starting again? This game is curing my existential phobias because it's making me realize that when you die, you actually just return to the last time you saw a creepy statue. And you were looking up at the stars. And so now I no longer fear death, obviously. Now that I know what happens. Let's try that again. Fear death, not me. Why would I? Not when you're a weird blue alien. I think maybe the reason that I shouldn't float around in space with just the jetpack is because it's perhaps easier when you have the ship. What is that? That is the Addle Rock. Okay. That's where I've been trying to go. Oh yeah, that is easier. That's way easier. Velocity. Zooming in. Moving forward. Alright, this might be it. I might be finally getting to the Ash Twin. Here we go. Come on.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay, now... going to go to C. To land. Thrust upwards. Okay, gentle. Gentle. No, I don't want to use sticky keys. Come on. I'm not using sticky keys right now. Trying to... I did it. Fuck yeah, I did it. Successful landing. Finally, took me long enough. All right, let's get out there. Not a whole lot. Fire jetpack booster. I don't want to. I don't think I want to do that. But is this planet just empty? Is this just an ice giant? Just a big wintry wasteland with nothing on. Oh, it's me. That could be something? No. That's a different planet. That could be something? Yes, these are something. What have I found? Gravity here seems normal. Oh my gosh, this game is very pretty. Somebody else's ship. You could find that. You go check them out. That place is crazy. What is that? What am I even looking at? Oh, that's the, I guess that's like the thread that connects the two planets, and there's my ship, so I went all the way around. Interesting. Let's get out of here. Didn't find anything good. But... was a successful landing, and that's a victory. Bring up the map. Brittle Hollow, Dark Bramble, Giant's Deep. I want to... I'm gonna go back to Giant's Deep. There it is. There's that old boy. I'm coming for you. Oh man, what a nice day. Surely nothing bad will happen to this solar system. Well, you know, from your mouth to his ears. No, baby, no. Fuck, no. Oh, God. Shit. Again. This planet has very strong gravity. Exit ship to repair. Starboard hull damaged. Alright. Surely I will have no choice. Whoop! Bonk. Yeah, I kind of parked in a bad place. I guess that's on me. tornado. Pick up control module protection stone. Okay. Insert control module protection stone. Oh, that's the easiest puzzle I've ever done in my life.
Whoa.
What happened? Oh, and I'm back. Hold to translate. Translated know my writing.
I gotta stretch.
Ooh, that feels good. I will translate. Computer, translate! 7 minutes, 17 seconds ago, long-range probe successfully launched from the orbital probe cannon. That's all it says? Okay. Ship log updated. Do I want to go over there? Let's try going over. I have my jetpack, right? Oh, it barely works on this planet because the gravity is so extreme? Oh, okay. I can walk on these things. Interesting. Ooh, this is trippy. This is gonna make me dizzy. Try going in there. That looks like civilization in there. Boop. Trees detected. Oxygen tank refilled. Okay, good. Pick up scroll. Drop scroll. Hello? Anyone home? Hello? Ooh, what is? Anything? Nothing? That's not coming this way, is it? Yeah, it might be. Whoop, yeah, boy. Ooh. What happened? The planet's gravity is gone now? Oh, jeez. Oh, boy. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, okay. Okay, back to normal. Interesting. Oh, and now we're underwater. This planet is a hot mess. This is a hot mess of a planet. Okay. Get back to my ship. No, oh gee. Okay. Ship is up there. How am I gonna get in there? Oof. Hey, here's someone's bones? Are you alright? Okay, I'm gonna try. Let's go underwater. Yep, that works. Okay. Let's try plugging in this stone, see what that does. I parked in the worst possible place. Truly the worst. Yes, okay. Already holding brittle hollow projection stone. Put that down. take this one, literally throw it right in the fucking ocean. No, I can't. I can only put it down. Okay. Put this one in.
Another vision. Spirit, why do you plague me with these visions? Why, Spirit? Why? You plague me with your visions.
Let's see if I can get back in that ship. Oof. Ooh. It's vibrating. Alright, this is gonna be tricky. This is gonna be a tricky It's not gonna work, but I have to try anyway. It's the only way to get back inside my ship. Yep.
Nope. Oh boy.
I knew that wasn't gonna fucking work.
Come on.
I've never played a game that's made me feel less in control of my movement. But I suppose it makes sense. I think it's hailing again. I can hear it.
Come on! Ugh.
Am I fucked? Can I just not get my ship back now?
$11.11 from Bethy Nuts Turdwell.
Hey, what's up?
Max, are you planning to view the eclipse on Monday?
Sure, why not?
I don't see why not. I enjoy a good eclipse. Let's hope it's a good one and not a horrible eclipse!
I can't get back there. I'm fucked. I'm screwed. What can I do? The game must have some kind of a failsafe if you get stranded, right? Like, the game must have something like that, right? It has to. Because I keep finding myself getting stranded constantly. How on earth did I even park there? I'm in trouble. Oh, and tornado is coming. Great! Brilliant! Great! 3 minutes oxygen remaining. Also great!
I'm not afraid of you! I'm not scared of you! I ain't afraid of no damn big twister!
Whoa! Okay, wait a minute. This is my chance! Oh, doggone! Oh, gee. Nope, I'm done. I'm fucking done. This game is harder than I was expecting. Yeah, I remember that. I did all that stuff. Is this the existentialism we've heard so much about? Maybe. What the game has taught me so far is that if you wander in space, something will kill you. You won't have long to live if you wander in space. But at the same time, how can you resist the allure of the space wander? I do always want to get right back out there every time I bite the dust. View the map. Where have I not been yet? There's something called the Interloper. Hourglass Twins, already been there. Giants Deep, Giants Deep, the place with the crazy gravity, I'll have to remember that. Brittle Hollow. Don't think I've been there. Let's try for... Next, let's try for, Brittle Hollow or Dark Bramble. One of those two. Hey, Wolfo's here. Lie down, bud. Don't bug me, just lie down. Brittle Hollow. Well, what do you know? You got a planet in the way. Alright, let's see if I can do this. Velocity matched. Forward thrusters. Forward thrusters on. Velocity matching again. Good. There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I am so learning. I'm getting so good at this. Backward thrust! Backward thrust! God! Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe not. Okay. Shush. Go lie down. Pre-flight checklist. What does that mean? Pre-flight checklist. Jetpack auto booster. Translator auto equip. Freeze time when translating text. Freeze time when... While reading ship log. Are these just like general game settings? Freeze time while talking to others. That would have been useful. That would have been useful when I was talking to that guy and I suddenly died and I don't know why it happened. This will prevent character animations from playing during conversations. I don't like that. There are certain periods when time cannot be frozen. Jetpack boost can be triggered with a separate button press manual or any time upward thrust is used, auto. Okay.
One small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.
Jeez! I was like, that's my worst nightmare. I was like, that's not gonna collide, is it? Damn. I've had so many nightmares like that where there are just giant rocks falling, giant flaming rocks falling from the sky. It's horrifying. Wolfo, go lie down, bud. Ooh. Ancient ruins. Oh, speak of the devil, there's another one. Wolfo, shush. Unidentified signal nearby. Hey, hey. Go lie down. Come on. Go lie down. Unidentified signal nearby. Okay. Wait a minute. I want to see this place from the top. Before I go inside, untranslated Nomai writing. Bells, beneath your feet lies the tower of quantum knowledge. Cool. Plume, the trees are moving. The trees in this grove wander about freely. The entire plant, roots, and all. This is not normal. Yeah, you can say that again. Even for this alien planet, and I never see them move. Is that even possible? Wolfo, for fuck's sake, go lie down. He thinks if he just walks around in circles, I'll have to pay attention to him eventually. But I won't do it. Alright, let's try going inside. Gravity isn't too bad. Launch scout. Retrieve scout. Rotate camera? Alright. Interesting. Could could this be, I wonder? Do we want to touch this? Oh. It's like an elevator? Oh, cool. Oh. That's so pretty. They turn into squares as you get farther to the bottom. There's more of those surfaces you can work sideways on. Or can you? Yeah, sort of. Dap. Ouch. Bells, be welcomed in this place. Above you stands the Tower of Quantum Knowledge. If you are making your first pilgrimage to the Quantum Moon... Am I doing that? Ascend these stairs and obtain the last of the knowledge you need for your journey. Whoa. Get that off of there. Scout removed. Remove scroll. Insert scroll. Why do I want scroll? Oh, that's why. Because I can use it to control things. Like the elevator. I gotcha. Equip translator. The crossroads. This is crossroads? Ooh, interesting. Brings it back to me. If I point it that way, I can... Hup! Yeah! Oh, fuck yeah! I love that! Oh, that's so fun! Yes! Hell yeah. Oh, that's great. Alright, let me try going this way. That's awesome. This game knows how to make me happy. Somebody playing the banjo? Is that you, Dippy Dog? Dippy Dog, are you playing the banjo? Talk to Ryback? I found someone!
I thought you were a dang old Dippy Dog.
Drop the scroll. Can I drop the scroll? Yes. Scroll dropped. And you're some kind of a Dippy Dog, yes?
Oh, you launched. That's great. Great job, you. Wow, I guess that means I've been out here for a while, huh? Well, this is Brittle Hollow, but you probably knew that.
I actually didn't.
Lots of history here. It's great.
What are you doing here?
I'm here to see the Hanging City. It's always been my dream to see with my own four eyes, ever since I was a hatchling. An alien race lived in this solar system long before our species even existed. How could I not want to see what their civilization was like? Only, you've probably heard the others say it, right? I'm afraid of space. Seriously, I'm more surprised than anybody that I'm out here. Do you want to know how I even got this far? I fell. I tripped over a gravity crystal. It's dumb luck I landed somewhere my little scout says is halfway stable instead of being sucked into what's below. I've been gauging the stability of the ground around me using my little scout, and this seems to be the place with the best surface integrity, so I'm just gonna stay here until I'm ready to move on. But that's enough about me and my problems. You didn't come all this way to listen to me blather, did you? That'd be... yeah.
I learned something. What did I learn? What should I explore here? What are you doing out here? What should I explore here?
Oh, wow! Where shouldn't you explore here? Not the black hole, actually. That's very no. which is unfortunate because, the most exciting stuff is all below the crust, including the Hanging City. That's just to the north. You can kinda see it from here. There's also this big dome on the South Pole called the Southern Observatory. You can't get inside from the surface, trust me, I tried. But if it's like the rest of the Nomai structures here, there's probably a path in it beneath the crust somewhere. Good luck with exploring. If you learn anything about the Nomai, I'd love to hear it, if it's not too much trouble.
I learned something.
Oh, cool. What is it?
Actually, never mind. Okay, so I have to learn things and then report back to this guy, I'm guessing.
Shut up! Damn!
Fuck you! Go lie down!
Oh, okay. If you do learn something new about the Nomai, though, I'd love to hear it. If you don't mind, I mean.
What are you doing out here?
Me? I'm an archaeologist, remember?
Come out to do some archaeologizing.
Or, the archaeologist, I guess, seeing as I'm all Timber Heart's got right now. Riddle Hollow is rich with Nomai history. That's why I'm here. This planet is an absolute treasure trove of culture, history, and science.
What are you doing?
He's so fucking bored.
Excuse me. If you have any questions about the Brittle Hollow Nomai, I'm your Hearthian. Or, I have some knowledge of them, I mean. So, maybe I can help?
See you later. Wolfo is going nuts right now. He's getting all hyperactive. He's got the zoomies. That cat do have the zoomies, though. That's the black hole, probably, yeah. Don't want to touch that. He just ran into the other room and he started going,
wow! Wow! Wow!
Yes, I'm talking about you. This will take me... This one goes up, so this one... Yep, can't get into there. This one brought me here. Oh, I don't need that thing. I don't need that thing to activate these, do I? I just hover my mouse over it. Which is good, because I put that thing down and I don't remember where I put it. Here? I don't even know.
Bling, 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 bling.
If I recall, I can walk on surfaces with crystals. Go up this way. Whoop. Is this the end of the line? Oh, I can go over here. Okay. Unidentified signal nearby. Gravity Canyon, east 400 meters. What is this? Herg. Well, that was deeply unpleasant. I made it this far, though. Guess that's the part to focus on, and not how I'll eventually have to get back up that path. But now, this place sure is something. Looks like the Hanging City is north from here, and east is a gravity canyon. I definitely want to see that. And another thing, I'm detecting oxygen from somewhere below, which is good since I used up a lot of my supply screaming during the trip down from the surface. As soon as I stop dry heaving, I'm going to head farther down below so I can refill my tank. Okay. They keep talking about north and east, but I don't have a compass, so I don't know how useful that's going to be. They said Hanging City to the north. Gravity Canyon to the east, but where is east? Where is east? Where is weest? Where is weest? That is the real question. The Hanging City, north 250 meters. Am I looking north? Is this north? Is this the Hanging City? Gonna assume this is north.
City.
Wolfo, shush.
What's wrong with you? Hey. What's wrong with you? Wolfo. Oh my gosh, hang on. Hey, what are you doing? Can you not do that? Hey. What is your problem? Don't bite that. Don't chew on that. Stop it. You need to stop it, okay? You want my attention, you have it. What do you want? Oh, now you don't want my attention anymore. What do you want? Mwah. Go lie down, bud.
Okay. Back to my filthy evil, I guess. I don't think I need my flashlight here. Ship log updated. Hanging City this way? Black hole forge controls. Am I doing something to the black hole beneath me? Moving that thing up and down, clearly. Herm. But do I want that thing down there? Do I want it up or down? I do not know what it is.
$5 from Zaki. Max,
Zaki.
Don't you want me, baby? Don't you want me? Ooh. You know I don't believe you when you say that you don't need me.
Are those song lyrics? School district. Meltwater district. Eye shrine district. Eye shrine with my little eye. Black hole forge district. Oh boy. Can I walk on this? Can I walk on this wall? Yes. Whoop! Bonk! Ayer! Bonk! 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 Ow! 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 3 minutes oxygen remaining. Bad. Truly bad. Is this the Hanging City? Am I in the Hanging City? Is there anything anywhere? Up there? Danger, ghost matter detected nearby. That's bad. Wai-ba-boo-ba-boo! Am I okay? No, I'm not okay. Killed by ghost matter. Oop. Alright, we'll go out one more time. One more little excursion. Every time I wake up, I see something going on here, but I don't know what that is. I don't know what's happening there. I don't know what I'm looking at. It looks like there might be some kind of a ship that explodes there, maybe? Every time I wake up, I see the same damn thing. Oh. Which planet is the green planet again? Giant's Deep. Does that mean that Giant's Deep is where I'm supposed to go first? Let's try going back there. Where do it be? There it be. Put that away. Okay. All right, I'm going for a perfect landing this time. Ooh, there's... Is that it? Is that the thing? Right there? I think that's the thing. I think I've discovered the thing. Can I land on it? I'm gonna land on it. Or not. Nope. Nope.
Shoot, come on! God!
Oh. This planet... This is the crazy gravity planet. Okay. Maybe I can land on that. I can't... Oh.
Ugh, come on.
Wait a minute. Okay. Let's see if I can find that guy again. He was not there. He had a little alcove. He's gotta be here somewhere. Here we go. This looks right. Come on. Work with me, baby. Okay, come on.
No.
Okay. And gentle. Oh. Okay. All right. Not my worst landing. Not my worst. Let's get the fuck out of here. Hey, man. What's up? Let's finish that conversation we were having. I was hoping you'd be back. You remember when I died? You remember that? Do you think we're in a time loop? We're definitely in a time loop. Something really weird is going on. Well, if I was stuck in a time loop that repeated every time I died, that would be a very advantageous time loop. So I think I would be okay with that. Oh yeah, that makes sense. Cool. You're taking this pretty well. Heh, right back at you. Personally, I like new experiences. I've never been in a time loop before. Well, I don't think I've been in a time loop before this one, but then it's not like I can know that for sure. So it looks like you and I are the only ones who know we're in a time loop. And even if I tell them about it, no one remembers by the next loop. What's with that? Well, why are we the ones who remember? Maybe it's because we both made some seriously intense eye contact with a Naomi statue. I'm just gonna keep saying Naomi. I see those letters, and I don't even bother reading the word. I'm seeing my memories replay each time I die, just like I did when the Naomi statue on the beach opened its eyes and looked at me. So maybe, no glowing statue, no time loop awareness. I think that's going to be my leading theory, but if you find out anything new about the statue or the time loop, let me know, okay? I'll be here. So, what's new? What are you doing out here? Well, what are any of us doing here, really? Nah, I'm just kidding. I'm out here exploring our solar system, same as you. But I tell you what, outer space really gives you room to think. It's quiet and peaceful out here. I can't speak today. Very mush mouth today. I mean, it's usually quiet and peaceful. Sometimes a cyclone comes by and lifts my little island paradise clean out of the water. Then, less peaceful. Where should I explore on Giant's Deep? Here's something you might like. At the start of every time loop, I keep seeing a bright flash in the sky. Something must be happening up there in orbit around the planet. Slow down, read slow, read slower. What else? Have you been to Statue Island? That's what I've been calling it. seeing as it's the island where I found the glowing Naomi statue. Get it? I was on the beach on Statue Island when the whole glowy business happened. By the way, it's a nice beach for that kind of thing. I give it a solid 7 out of 10 on the Gabbro relaxation scale. If you feel like checking out Statue Island, it's the one with two islands connected by a natural rock arch. Or arc. Well, mostly connected anyway. You'll see. Let me get a sip. What's up with this planet? Ha, I know, right? Oh, you meant like, tell you more about it? I gotcha. Well, Giants Deep is massive and mostly water. No surprises there. There's a strong current a ways beneath the surface that prevents anything from sinking below it. Seriously, I tried everything I could think of to get past that current, and neither idea worked. As for land masses, I've counted 4 islands, including this one. There's also the one with the Naomi statue I saw on the beach. You've seen the cyclones. Yeah, they're hard to miss. They'll toss up everything in their path, islands included. Little tip, if you get picked up, try to land in water. Less likely to kill you. See ya. Cool, take it easy out there. What a relief that nothing bad happened. Nothing bad happened that time. Anything in here? Danger, ghost matter detected nearby. What does that mean? Just means don't go too far in that direction. Okay. Do not touch the ghost matter. Warning, do not touch ghost matter. Good advice. What? What's happening? What's happening? No! No, not a tornado again. Oh, no. Try to land in water, he said. I'm not seeing a hell of a lot of water. I'm just gonna stay close to the ground. There we go. Alright. Crisis averted. Do I wanna go up there? It's gonna be tricky to go up there. Yeah, I don't think I can. This side or Herm. Uh-oh. Lightning? No, I'm good. Okay. More ghost matter.
Blip.
Jeez. Is it right there? Right immediately there? Yeah. I guess fucking so. Ooh, and a lot of it, too. A lot of it. Okay. He said there were 4 islands on this planet. Let's see if we can find one of the other ones. Come on. There we go. Was I wearing my suit?
probably. Use medkit and refuel jetpack. Yes, we'll do that. Okay. Other islands on this planet. There we go. Here we go. Where can I land? There? Oh, I've been here. Don't get out. If you get out here, you're fucked. Oh, jeez. This is like trying to parallel park. Come on. Exit ship to repair. Damage to... I can't blast off anymore. The gravity is fucked here. There we go. Okay. Let's go this way. Was this where I just was? No, this is new. Yes, perfect! Perfect landing. This game is, it's so big. I don't know how I would ever figure out where I'm supposed to direct my attention. I don't know how I'm ever supposed to make progress in it, because it's so big. Statue? Oh! Naomi, is that you? Naomi statue found. Statue workshop. I know these bad boys, I can walk here. Come on, let me find something right before I quit. Just to wet my whistle. Just to give me something to think about. Find something cool. Trees detected oxygen chank. How many times am I gonna say oxygen chank today? For fart's sake. These must be for a puzzle or so. I keep seeing these everywhere. The tornadoes. These I can read. Lami, they're going to test the memory statues tonight. Phlox says it could be dangerous, so we can't come. But what if we didn't use the door and snuck in the other way? Does anyone want to?
No.
Phlox specifically told us not to do that. I really want to see the test too, Lami, but there's a huge risk to take. We probably shouldn't. Maybe Phlox will let us see it later. Or maybe Phlox will let us see a later test. Nothing in terms of jetpack on this planet. You got nothing! Ugh, there we go. Maybe, I'm just spitballing here, but maybe the idea is I have to wait on one of these spots for a tornado to pick me up. And if I'm standing on one of these spots when a tornado picks me up, then something happens? Torches are guiding me out this way. Trees detected.
this anything? What is? What is? Oh my gosh, look at how this... Look at this complicated ass device. I'm sure this is a... I'm sure this isn't a puzzle I'll never be able to solve in a million years. Welcome to Giant's Deep, friends. I'm excited for you to meet the statues. If I'm not in my dwelling, I'm likely in my workshop below, inside the island. Okay, so there's a way to get inside of this island. Good to know. But also, I gotta call it quits. Does this game autosave? Is there autosaving in this game? Do I have to save some other way? Whoa. What happened? Ooh, wait. No! Oh, I wanted to find one of those things. Oh, yeah. Look, they're glowing now. Why are they glowing? Oh, I'm just going out to space. Yep. Oops. Oopsie doopsie. I'm just going out to space. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Gonna hurt. No. Okay. Not dead. I don't know if I can get back to where I was, though. It saves when you die. Okay. Can I get back to solid ground? Almost. There we go. Okay, and right next to my ship? How fortuitous. How serendipitous. How all the issuses. Alright. Hell yeah. One thing I haven't done yet is I haven't flown into the sun. So, let me try that. Try flying into the sun just to see what happens. Which will save my game if you... If your game is saved when you die. Oh, that's so cool. I love that. Bleh. Bleh. Maybe that ship blowing up is what's causing the time loop that we're stuck in. Because every time I wake up, I see that same ship blowing up again. Reset loop and quit to main menu? Yes. Well, that's a lot of fun. I enjoyed that. We can think about playing it again. I'm not so sure, but maybe. But that's gonna be it for today, which means it's time to wind things down. We had a few good laughs, my friends. trees, made a few memories. And although now the fun must end, I hope you see what you mean to me. You're all my neighbors and allies, and though it's time to part, as we traverse through lows and highs, I'll keep you all inside my heart. Sorry that it's time to go, but we can still share one more song. It's because I love you so that it hurts to say so long. Red and yellow, black and white, you're all precious in my sight. But it's time for us to say so long.
This is almost like the perfect Relax with Max game. It's a very peaceful, relaxing game. Lots of nice, calm music. You get to drift around in the stars. I like it. I had fun. Of course, it also... It seems like it might be a little too open-ended for its own good. Because even though I had some fun exploring, I also never really knew what I was supposed to be doing. Or how to make any progress. You know, I like an open-ended experience as much as the next guy, but sometimes I'm like, well, yeah, but I want to make progress, though. I want to move forward. And I wasn't quite sure how to do that, and I didn't really ever figure it out. But maybe we'll play again. I don't know. I'd like... Maybe. I'll think about it. I'd like to take a moment to encourage you all to consider joining my Patreon, which now is over 10 years of updates. For just $5 a month, you can get access to useful resources for artists and animators, such as source files, presets, and tutorials, and the link is in the description below. And if you're not interested in the art stuff, but you'd still like to support what I do, you can become a channel member right here on YouTube and get access to exclusive emotes in the chat. That's going to be it for me, folks. I'll see you on Monday for something. Don't know. Maybe this, maybe something else. And thanks to everyone who joined us for this stream. Thank you so much for inviting me into your home and allowing me to spend the afternoon with you. It's been an honor and a privilege. And remember, I am close personal friends with each and every one of you. So long.